In a time full of war, be peace. In a time full of doubt, just believe. Yeah, there ain't that much difference between you and me. In a time full of war, be peace. In a world full of hate, be a light. When you do somebody wrong, make it right. Don't hide in the dark, you were born to shine. In a world full of hate, be a light. In a place that needs change, make a difference. Noise, just listen. 'Cause life is but a breeze, better live it. In a place that needs to change, make a difference. In a world full of hate, be light. When you do somebody wrong, make it right. Oh, don't hide in the dark, you were born to shine. In a world full of hate,
line is 6 feet in the ground. In a race you can't win, just slow it down.
In a world full of hate, be a light.
Oh,
when you do somebody wrong, make it right,
make it right.
Don't hide in the dark, you were born to shine. In a world full of hate, see black and white. In a world full of hate, be a light.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you're having a good start of the weekend as you choose to be here on a Saturday morning. Welcome again to our online School of the Word. This is Sheila, a Verbum Dei disciple from Manila. Last week, Ate Joan invited us all to reflect about our response as we try to live the different realities we faced in the mystical body of Christ. For me, I am personally challenged by the questions whether I am lukewarm or cold-hearted with the situations I am facing. Since quarantine started, my perspective narrowed down into concerning myself only with personal things like my own plans, worries, problems in the family and at work. In my prayer last week, I am reminded by Jesus, with his call for me to be part of the mystical body, armed with his love and mercy to fight the indifferences that our society is facing. God calls each one of us to be part of the mystical body. Therefore, we must do our own part. But how? We may naturally limit ourselves about the things we can do, but as His beloved children, He believes in our capabilities and great potential. In Ephesians 2, verse 10, it says, "For we are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works." Being locked down in the safety of our homes may make us think that our life has already stopped, because we cannot do the things we normally do before. The things we want, the activities we want to pursue. And in terms of doing mission, it has become impossible to go to the others whom Jesus wants to reach out. Some news also concludes that emotional stability of most people has been greatly affected because of the panic and fear of getting the virus. However, Jesus thinks differently. Our life may be in quarantine, but life must continue, and life must go on. The quantity of our life already changed in terms of the things we do, but the quality shall remain the same, and the invitation is to lead a Christ-like life. And Jesus believes and holds on to each of our lives with great hope that we can continue the good works that you and I have started. We are created to reveal God's goodness and His good works. So, how to reveal God's goodness to others? It is through our lives, because it has a great influence on the mystical body of Christ. In my prayer, I recall the past 6 months that I've spent at home. It has been that long, and I never knew it would still continue like this. There were a lot of up and down moments. My prayer life was not always consistent. Relationships were not easy to deal with and sustain. At this moment, I invite you also to recall the moments you have spent for the past 6 months. How was it? What were the things so easy or difficult? While deepening this mystical body, I realized that the way I live my life with all the things I do greatly affects the people I am surrounded by. My family, my friends, the Verbum Dei community. When things are easy, I am able to reveal and continue the good works. But when things are hard, I lack the motivation to even start the work and think of the great influence it will have to other people. I cannot do it on my own, and it is only through prayer that I am convinced that my life can impact other people's lives. With that, it is through prayer which renews my strength, because Jesus encourages me to continue persevering in the things that I am doing, to never lose hope, and to continue sharing the Word of God, to allow His Word to transform not only my life, but the life of others. I suddenly remember the young teens in Alabang from our missionary journeys. It was always a joy to be with them, to hear their stories, to share in their laughter and in their sorrows. Every time we have our talk, I observe that there are two types of audiences that we have. The noisy side of the group and the quiet and the listening group who behaves and participates actively in our activity. While thinking of these specific moments, I reflected how each audience type influences other audiences, which are the other teens. The noisy ones, when they are many, they will manage to convince or influence others to become noisy as well. But when we, the team, manage to quiet most of the teens in the audiences, they will all quiet down and the noisy ones will become shy. And then they will not misbehave anymore. Why did I say this? It is because today and every day, we encounter positive and negative influences in our daily lives. Those we managed to quiet down and were influenced by the already quiet and listening teens were able to listen to our shh and to our talk, and to the Word of God. We are called to be the light and the salt in this world, in the mystical body of Christ. In Matthew 3, You are the salt of the earth. But if salt has lost its taste, how shall its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled under people's feet. Matthew 5, verses 13 to 16. When we don't make efforts in sharing the word of God, in preaching and reaching out others, we may lose the essence of God's word in our lives. We may lose our positive influence to other people. We will lose our chance to be heard by the people God has entrusted to us in our call of mission. In our MJ, we share the verbum Dei truths of faith. And every time we give our talk, I would always go back to my prayer while I was in the community, how it sustained me, because I believe it will also be the same prayer that can help these young teens go through the hardships of their life, sharing to them that the prayer life, and through the love of God, that they may continue living the life, that they may continue living the life that Jesus wants them to live. I noticed that the noisy group in our MJ are sitting closely with each other, and after being with them in the group sharing and staying with them, I realized, oh, they are good friends. Barkada pala sila. And in 1 Corinthians 15, verse 33, it says, "Do not be deceived. Bad company ruins good morals." I'm not saying that they were bad persons, literally, but I'm just pointing out the negative influence we can have with other people, especially if we go with this kind of people, with these negative habits or situations that are bad for us in general. It can affect how we listen to God, how we interpret His words, and how we reach our goal, which is to lead a Christ life. Which is to lead a Christ-like life. If we do not manage to shh the many negative noises of our society, of our habits, people, and the situations we have, they will continue to grow because we did nothing. They will continue to roar louder because all we do is just listen to them. Instead, we must do something to fight the noises. We know that we have passed from death to life because we love each other. Whoever does not love abides in death. 1 John 3 verse 14. Like how Jesus did, He invites us to love and accept the reality we are in, to persevere in loving the now because sooner or later, it will be better. He promised that after death, there will be life, only if we will just love others. So, let us spread love and goodness in this time of lockdown. To our friends whom we haven't talked for a while, to our community, to ask how we can help and extend assistance, to love without counting the cost. What must we do in order to influence others positively? When I asked myself about this, initial thoughts were, what are the personal things that I can do? But Jesus told me in my prayer, to seek His ways, to seek His thoughts, to pray longer the how, and not to be pressured by the question of it. To reflect on what kind of member of the mystical body am I to be, and not just what I want to be. To reflect on the gifts that I receive from Him, so that I can offer it to build the body of Christ. Let your light shine before others. Matthew 5, verse 16. Being light does not mean we should do grand things so we can really shine in someone's life, but doing what we know we can for the person we know. I remember a colleague of mine whom I am close at the office. We became close because our personality just clicked right away, because I am so immersed with his life stories. We are from different departments, and he is very much stressed about his workload to the point that he does not eat on time unless I pushed him or pressure him that I will not eat as well. There were also times that he will ask if I am available for a couple of minutes because he wanted to cry out his emotions, and I will gladly make some time even though there are pending workloads on that day. For me, I knew that he needed someone who can genuinely be there for him and just listen to everything. Our little gestures of love can be something big for others, so do not underestimate our little acts, because we never know how it could brighten and give hope to another person. At this moment, I invite you to recall those little moments you had with your loved ones, or even with a stranger, that you think you were able to become a light to them. Jesus is happy knowing we have shared his light to the other members of his mystical body. I pray to God that in this time, may I continue to learn how to be present and not look back at the past mistakes and not to overthink the future. To hold the present like how God and Jesus' presence continues to work in my life right now. To practice patience at all times, because the world has been impatient with a lot of issues and things, so that in doing so, we may truly understand each other and work together for the good of all. And lastly, to seek wisdom from God, that amidst the fear and uncertainties, God will always be in control. All he needs is to do our part. Let our life shine brightly so that others can also lead a life that is same with us and Jesus. A life filled with love and light. Amen.
Thank you. As we end this moment of prayer, we are invited to offer our Thanksgiving prayer in writing in the comment section. Also, we are invited to carry a concrete person in prayer through this week, praying for their situation that they are living, and also for one another, to be living witnesses of hope and love as Vavum Day.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Jerry, a Vavum Day disciple. I've known Vavum Day for quite a long time, and this is where I developed a personal relationship with Jesus through prayer. This personal interaction with Him leads to my inner conversion, which automatically brings me out of myself and proclaim Him to the world in my word and action, wherever I am, whoever I'm with, and in whatever situation. I consider this grace as a gift from God, because the desire of who I was is already transformed into who He is. Thus, I don't really consider it as a distinct goal that I need to be consciously diligent in achieving, but rather as my way of life that needs to be spontaneously lived with joy in partnership with Jesus, who guides me in the path that He has already trodden. In such case, it doesn't become an obligation, not even a responsibility, but a reflex, not aiming on consciously projecting Jesus, but simply an awareness that He is with me and in them, therefore responding to life as personally responding to Him. Many years back in the company that I work, I had the privilege to be entrusted by the several expats with the confidence to be consulted on all matters in the company, even beyond the scope of my official assignment. Then came the change of the new expat, who I also know well and considered as a friend. Yet suddenly, weeks after the turnover, his dealing towards me totally changed, pressuring me and seemingly doubtful of all my actions, without any valid reason at all. Then it seeped through the managers under me to the extent that it already affected not only me, but the rest of the employees in the company, who seemed confused on what's happening. After a few months of bearing with the situation, which was only made possible through a constant and serious prayer life, I approach him and specifically ask, "What have I done to you that warrants this kind of treatment? I thought we were friends prior to your assignment in the Philippines." He could not answer me, but just said that many of my managers are complaining about me, yet he could not divulge their names because I might go after them. I expounded to him how I personally hired these people, trained, nurtured, and promoted them, treating everyone as a brother emphasizing that communication should be open for a harmonious relationship towards achieving the company's goals, approached in all fairness and following the rules of the company. But he insisted otherwise. Then I mentioned that we are a family here because we only have one God as our Father. Suddenly he blurted, "But you do not see your God." I calmly said that God is present in him, in me, and in every person, and he manifests himself in the way we treat each other in love. Then he was quiet. You see, he's a Buddhist, and we already have the show in the office that the missionary conducts and even the previous expats are aware of because I introduced them. Then he said, if I'm willing to meet with the complainants, but the condition that it should be simultaneous with the five of them. And I obliged. The following day, the meeting was arranged, and one after the other, they pinned me down with distorted complaints, packed with malice and lies, all matters of which were already settled. I was praying all the time to the Holy Trinity, feeling exactly the situation of Jesus in front of Pilate, with the similar people who I thought I was able to bring up well. I opened my response with a question. You mean that all these years you have not been true to me? And I clarified in every detail all their concerns in full objectivity, yet not leaving behind the compassion in every situation. Of course, no matter how solid they fabricate the lies, the truth will always prevail. And so the expat said, now, Jerry has addressed all your concerns. What else do you want? They attempted to collectively pursue against me, but the expat excused himself and concluded the session. Immediately the following day, and years after, he was reaching out to me, and our friendly and professional relationship was re-established. Funny, because when the antagonists witnessed this, they clung back to me, mudslinging the expat this time. But it became an opportunity for me to reintroduce a balanced relationship with each other with respect and forgiveness, often not missing the corresponding Bible passage as support, while consistently inviting them to the show and retreats of Verbum Dei. I discovered later that it was orchestrated by someone in position whose main function is to develop harmony and performance excellence in the company, the same person who I hired, trained, recommended for promotion, and partly was a confidant. It was all because of envy, greed, and desire for power. In the end, brotherhood was re-established, but the instigator, although apologized, continued to scout for the time to strike again. Here I was reminded of the temptation of Jesus after 40 days of fasting in the desert. In the last day of the expat, he openly mentioned in his speech that Jerry was right. We did not start well because I listened to so many voices. But what's important is, we are still friends. It is not easy to be light in a world of many fears and lies. Yet, it is possible to let the light of Christ shine in our minds, in our confusion, in our decisions, in our options. May the Lord of Light give us courage to be light of the world and salt of the earth.
Is it enough just to be good, to follow orders and the shoots? Is it enough to be so cool? Is it enough just to wait for life to
be. Speak my word with your life. Follow me, yes, it's all right. I'm your way, your truth, your life. Speak my word with your life. Follow me, yes, it's all right. I'm your way, your truth, your life. Oh, speak my word.
Lord, take a look.